Good morning, everybody. Just to say welcome to our online worship this morning, wherever or whenever you're watching. It's lovely to share this time of worship with you.
Our prayers today have a Celtic feel, and I'm going to read first from the Psalms, Psalm 29 and verses 3 to 4. The voice of the Lord is over the waters, the glory of God thunders. The Lord thunders over the mighty waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is majestic. When I say, the Lord reigns, let earth be glad, in your mind or even out loud, respond, and the distant shores rejoice. The Lord reigns, let the earth be glad, and the distant shores rejoice. You who spoke this world in motion, breathed life into every creature, painted landscapes in colourful hues, you are our God. The Lord reigns, let earth be glad, and distant shores rejoice. You who bring us each season light and warmth, rain and sunshine, and within the seed a spark of life, you are our God. The Lord reigns, let earth be glad, and distant shores rejoice. You whose love is beyond measure and stretches throughout time, from a garden in Eden to Gethsemane and beyond, you are our God. The Lord reigns, let earth be glad and distant shores rejoice. By the word of our Lord the heavens were made, by the spirit of our Lord was life begun. By the wisdom of our Lord his laws were laid, by the love of our Lord was born his Son. By the grace of our Lord, humanity was saved. By the power of our Lord, the victory was won. A prayer of confession. Creator God, forgive our moments of ingratitude. The spiritual blindness prevents us from appreciating the wonder that is this world, the endless cycle of nature, of life and death and rebirth. Forgive us for taking without giving, reaping without sowing. Open our eyes to see, our lips to praise, our hands to share. May our feet tread lightly on the path we tread, and our footsteps be worthy of following, that they may lead to you. Amen. And now we join together in the prayer that Jesus gave us, as we say, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive others that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
You today.
So you're not from around here.
It's hard to explain. I keep having these memories. I see flashes. I think I had a life here. But I can't tell if it's real.
We have no idea what threats are out there. We can't do this alone. We need you.
I'm not what you think I am.
Hello, I am Adele and I am a parish nurse that works within the community. So when I was asked to talk about the challenges our world and specifically our community is faced with, I could list them so easily. See, life has a lot of hardships, especially at the moment, and people are really struggling to make ends meet, even if they've never struggled before. The cost of living, fuel prices, all rising. And on top of that, the pressure of social media to be this perfect person with this perfect life in every aspect. But how to fix it? Now, this was trickier. Of course, as a Marvel fan, my wandering brain instantly sees an image of Captain Marvel in all her glory. Now, those of you that don't know, she is the ultimate superhero. In my opinion, other superheroes available, of course. Her powers outweigh any of the others by far, so much so that she normally arrives at the very end of the battle, because the makers know that if she arrived at the beginning, it would be such a short film. When she arrives, everyone in the cinema just thinks, you are in for it now. And it's certain that whatever side she chooses, they will be victorious. My mind then wanders, because I'm musically minded, to a song that I love. It's called Reckless Love. Now, the song talks of an unstoppable superpower that we all have in our back pocket and that would put Captain Marvel right in her place. The love and strength of God. The overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Now, I want to interject something really important here and go slightly off track. If you are struggling to hear that God loves you and how much he loves you, or you're struggling to believe it, I completely understand. It is so hard to comprehend that, especially if times are tough. But I really urge you that you will talk to somebody or pray with somebody, because the more we can comprehend that, and that amazing love he has for us, the more it can be life-changing. You see, whilst thinking about this song, I realise that this dawning moment when Captain Marvel arrives and everyone in the cinema thinks, you're up for it now. That's how God's opposition must feel when we declare our love for God, when we welcome him into our lives. When we're beaten down and life is tough, when we're comparing ourselves unfairly to other people, either on social media or real life, and when we look in the fridge or at our bank accounts and don't quite know how the next week is going to work. But despite all that, we still pray in Jesus' name. Anyone and anything opposing God must think, wow, we are in for it now. Now, something I've learned the hard way quite recently is that this love isn't always shown the way we would like. There are moments that we would love God to miraculously shoot from the sky and fix absolutely everything. Now, in reality, he doesn't always work like that. We have to remember he works in his perfect timing, not our worldly timing. And a lot of the time when we look back, we will realise the whys and the wherefores. But what I am certain of is that his unstoppable, reckless love is for us and with us. Now I'm going to prove how much I love music, because the next thing that comes into my brain straight away is the bridge of another song. And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? Now the only thing I would change in this otherwise perfect bridge is the word if. Because it implies that God's love is up for debate. And in my opinion, it's more of an inevitable, unstoppable force. One of my favourite Bible verses is Philippians 4:13. For I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. And this reminds me daily that God is on my team, our unstoppable team. And he is for me, for all of us. So we know who will be victorious, don't we? Now, if you could join me in a prayer, I would love that. Lord, we are so blessed to have your unstoppable strength and love that is for us and with us. Remind us daily that because you are for us, then nothing can ever stop us. And because you are with us, nothing can stand against. You are our amazing God, and we are here to follow and serve you. We love you, Lord. Amen. Thank you so much for listening, and God bless.
So maybe you feel like you're walking in the dark at the moment. Maybe you feel like you can't feel that love of God in your life. In response to Adele's message, I want you to spend some time just listening to the words of this next song and meditating on how much God loves you. Keep repeating it to yourself. Be assured of his love, his care for you, even when the path is unclear. So as we listen, let's meditate on these words together.
Before I spoke a word, you were singing over me. And you have been so, so good to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You have been so, so kind to me. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found, leaves the 99 I couldn't earn, and I don't deserve it, still you away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. When I was your foe, still your love fought for me. And you have been so, so good to me. When I felt no worth, you paid it all for me. You have been so, so kind to me. And oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found, don't deserve it, still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Yeah.
shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. No wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me.
So we bring our prayers of intercession. During the prayers, there will be opportunity for you to say your own private prayers. Let us pray. Dear Lord, we come to you quietly and peacefully. We come to you in prayer. We bring our prayers for others and for situations. And we ask that you will bring your loving arms. Bring your love, your forgiveness, your mercy. And we ask for your intervention where possible in the situations we pray for. Dear Lord, we pray for a world in turmoil. We pray for people across the world who are unable to afford to go to a shop, unable to afford to put fuel in their cars. We pray for people who are facing the prospect of becoming homeless or facing the choice between putting food on the table or turning the heating on. Lord, we bring these situations to you and we ask for your intervention. And quietly, Lord, we bring our own prayers to you. And Lord, we pray for the political world, especially in the UK and in Northern Ireland. We pray for the Northern Irish Assembly where we just have disarray. We pray for the real people who are affected because the politicians there are unable to make real decisions. And we pray for the ongoing provisions and security provided by the Good Friday Agreement. And Lord, we pray for the UK. We pray for our new Prime Minister. We pray for some wisdom amongst our politicians that they can make decisions that make people's lives easier, that ensure the people who need it have what they need. We pray for all these things, and in a moment we bring you our own reflections on this now. And Lord, in this season which can be so uncertain, autumn moving into winter, as the cold comes, as the long nights draw in, we pray for our churches, that they can be a beacon of light, that they can be a warm space, that we can give what we need to our communities to ensure that people are warm and fed, and that they have someone they can talk to and turn to when they need them. Lord, we bring our own prayers to you now. And Lord, we pray for our families, we pray for the people around us, we pray for our friends, we pray for our loved ones. We only know our own situations, and so in a moment of prayer, we bring our family and friends and people we love to you. Lord, we pray because we know you listen. We pray today that you listen to our prayers. We listen to the petitions of our hearts, that you will be in all of these situations. We do so because we know you listen, and where possible, you intervene. We love you, Lord. Amen.
Thank you for sharing worship with us this morning. As usual, if there's anything that you want any help with, please just get in touch in all the usual methods. It's been lovely to share with you. Thank you.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.